Morning, guys. Welcome back to Your Florida Electrician. Today we got a bunch of GFI outlets to do on our new home addition. I would like to do at least one. This one, it goes over to this one. And this is kind of a new product. I'd like to show how to do this one as well. It's a receptacle with two USB ports. And I'd like to show you how that goes in as well with this GFI. Okay, first things first. Let's make sure there's no power because this is already connected in the panel. And I got my handy dandy little tick tester here from Klein. A lot of people hate these things, but if you know you have power on here, don't forget, don't ever forget. And you test it, and this is saying there's no power, you're good to go. Some people make the mistake of it's not on, and then they test it and think the power is not on. Big mistake. Okay, there's nothing. We're good. So this outlet, this GFI will be feeding another GFI right next to it. Not GFI, another outlet next to it. So how we do it out in the field is line side will always be twisted. Basically, the one coming from the electrical panel, that has to be on the line side. The load side on here is always covered with a piece of tape or something. And they have to be in that order. If they're not in that order, the GFI won't work properly. So we have to identify which one's which. This one goes right to the panel. If you didn't know which one was which and it's connected in the electrical panel, you could take this, knowing that it's off, okay, strip it if you think this is the line side. We have another handy dandy tool from Klein. This one just will give you a light if there's voltage. So I would like to test this to see if it's the right one. Let's see if I can get this on the camera. All right, I'm gonna hold this like this. Don't touch it with your fingers. All right, see the lights light up all the way up to 120 volt. Starts off 24, 48, 120, but not 240. So this is, in fact, is the right side, the line side. I'm gonna go shut it back off. So you have your GFI device. Should have a strip gauge on the back. That's very hard to see. Oh, right there. See that little line? Right there? That's a strip gauge. So you strip your wire. You hold it along there, and that's how much insulation you take off. Okay? And I got it just right. So let's strip back the load side. About the same. All right, I'm gonna put this ground back in the box. I don't need all that ground out here. All right, found my knife. I need to cut this because I need to get that. GFIs use a lot of box, use a lot of room. I try to use a deep box. They have shallow boxes and deep boxes. This one's probably a 22. And a half cubic inch inside the wiring space. So yeah, sometimes this is like this. I'd rather have it like this than too far back. You can always trim it. Okay, now we can start wiring up our devices. Okay, on here is the ground. We want to put that in here. There's a little flat plate this goes under. You could wrap it around the screw, but they allow you to put it under here. I'm still using my torque setting of about 14 pounds. Ah, I forgot to set it to zero since last time I used it. They recommend that you put it back to zero every day when you're done. Okay, right there. Already 14 pounds. Wow, that's fast. Okay. And you see where this says line. Can you see that? Let's see if I can zoom in. See it says line right here? That's the one coming from the panel. This one is always going to be load. Okay, line side is the pair that's twisted. Okay, neutral on the silver ones. Okay, you need to torque it. I have a video about using this torque screwdriver. If I recall, I'll put a link or a card in the corner. How to use a torque screwdriver. It's handy. All right, this one's a little bit too long, I believe. No, it's good. There's my line side. All right, we're torqued there. Now my load side. My load side, I want to take this off. Okay, you can protect maybe 5 outlets downstream from this GFI. For here, we're going to only protect the one next to it. There's only going to be 2 devices, the GFI and this device next to it. Okay, so it should be pretty nice. I want to use this as a serving station. We're going to have a lot of power here for whatever, rice maker, cooker, popcorn machine, whatever we decide to do. All right, that one's a little bit too long. How do I know? It's sticking out a little bit. I can see the insulation. Cut that. Put it on. Tighten it till it clicks. I don't know if this has a different torque value. It doesn't say it on here. Okay, that one's a little bit too long also. And the reason why you don't want wire exposed is if you push this back in the box, the ground's going to get all bunched up, which is uninsulated copper. And if it hits this uninsulated hot wire, it's going to trip. You go to plug something in, and all of a sudden it touches when you plug it in, and boom. Okay, so let's see if you can see that. Let's see if I can zoom again. All right, you see? Very little, if any, insulation sticking above those screws. That's what we want. Okay, the ground facing down. There's a lot of wires here, and they're 12 wire, which is solid, which is a hard wire. So try to bend these wires and then push them in. Keep that ground pushed in. Kind of difficult. Excuse me. I'm got a little bit of a cold, flu or something. Nice. All right, we're going to come back to testing that in a minute. Then we got this guy. Look at this fancy guy. We got an outlet plus 2 USB chargers. I'm not sure what the speed is. Probably had it on the box. But I never installed one of these, this type. So I'm going to go ahead and put it in. And it's going to be fed off of that GFI. And let's see how that goes. All right, so let's get this device in there. It looks like it goes straight in on there, and same thing here, just goes straight in. So we don't have to put any curls on these wires, but we do need to strip the insulation off a little bit. Let me see the wire stripping gauge, if they have one on here. If it does have a wire strip gauge, I can't see it. So pretty good, you do about a 3/4 of an inch, 1/2 inch. Usually pretty safe. It looks like here they want it to go around the screw. It has a little guide for the ground coming out. Oh, that's slick. Okay, I like that. Pinch this. Torque. Okay, and my bit fell out. There's one. I'm excited to try this thing. All right, see the difference in the screw color? This one's silver, this one's copper. Your white wire goes here, black wire goes there. Pretty standard stuff. Don't confuse this with a stab in. It's not a stab in. All right, my wires are too long. Yep, trim them back a little bit. That means this one's gonna be too long too. Trim it while we're at it. Okay, good. Okay, I want to tighten that so it clicks. I'm not sure if it's the same for GFIs, but for receptacles, about 14 pounds. Okay, my hot side. Hold that there. Right there. There we go. And again, I need to trim some of this back. I need all this room for my receptacle. It's crowded already. Nice. Okay, cool. Again, put this back in the box, push the wires back, get them to bend a little bit, push it back in the box. Yeah, I can't wait to try this one. Get my little charger. Go turn the power on. Okay, if I did this right, reset this and it should come on. There's no power right now. Push the reset. All right, we got green light. That's good. Always check it later with a plug checker. Another awesome Klein tool. All right, trip when I put it in because I hit the button. Two orange light. That's what you want. Two orange light. There's a test trip button here. Yep. So the GFI is wired right, because we know, because it trips when I push the test trip. Okay, the outlet next to it, this new fancy pants with the USB. Let's see. All right, two orange. We're wired good. Two orange. Does it trip the GFI upstream? Yes, it does. So that is wired correctly. Now I'd like to charge, like to try the USB, see how that works. Hey guys, welcome back. Several weeks later, here's the finished product. We're still working on this, finishing it, but the cell phones are both charging with this new style outlet. Okay, plug these in. And it's pretty nice. We should be able to have a bunch of food here for a serving station, charge phones, whatever we want to use it for. Hey guys, thank you as always for watching. If you found any value in this video, please consider liking, subscribing, sharing, becoming a member for perks. And we do have super thanks if you really like this video and you want to send something under a super thanks. Really appreciate it. We'll see you on the next one.